Hey, what's going on, guys? Jeff Koga here, and wanted to make this quick video, and I want to talk about something called the rabbit and the turtle story, and how the Western teachings and philosophies has influenced you into believing, making you believe in a lie, all right? And I decided to talk about this is because I just finished a training that I just did right now, and I think it ties into some of the questions I get asked a lot, where people are constantly talking about, hey, you know what, I'm going to be simply more consistent, right, on what they do. So if you know about this childhood story, and how does the story go, right? It goes like this. It goes that once upon a time, a rabbit and a turtle got into an argument, and they said, oh, okay, who can finish a race? So they decided on a route, and they decided to race. They picked the finish line down the road, and they said, okay, let's race. And they said, ready, set, go. And then they took off. Now, you know the story. What happened? The rabbit, because he's faster than the turtle, he sprinted off and said, whew, he took off. Right? The turtle is slow, as we know, so he was going left, right, slow and steady. Right? And as the rabbit took off, running at full speed, he looked back and he was just like, whoa, the turtle's way behind me. Let me go ahead and relax a little bit, chillax a little bit, and let me hang out under this tree. And so guess what he did? He said, I'm going to rest here. And he took a little rest. And we all know the story and how it ended. He fell asleep, and then the turtle, because he was slow and steady and consistent, he went left, right, he beat them to the finish line, right? And the moral of the story is they always say, hey, be consistent, right? Even if you're going slow, be consistent, right? And we're taught this as a kid, okay? Especially in the Western world, all right? Now, in when I grew up, right, that was only one part of the story, actually, right? They added actually a couple stories, where they came back and the rabbit was so pissed off that they lost that the rabbit challenged the turtle again to a race. Because he realized that, guess what? He only lost because he actually stopped. He thought he was doing well and he stopped. Right? So he said, okay, let me go ahead and challenge you to a race again. And then the turtle said, sure, no problem. Okay? And this is the untold story. So they went, and guess what? They said, ready, set, go. Boom. Rabbit took off, and he didn't look back. He said, forget this. I am not going to rest this time. And guess what happened? He smoked the turtle, right? And he was on the finish line like, ha, 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 ha. I told you I'm the fastest. I'm the best, all right? And then the turtle got to the finish line, and the turtle was pissed off that he lost. He was just like, damn it, I lost. And people think that, hey, you know what, the moral of this particular story, right? They'll be like, hey, fast and consistent always wins. We know this. If you're fast, velocity, you put velocity behind, even in life, business, whatever you do, and if you're consistent about it, you're always going to outpace, what, the slow and steady. All right, always. It's just the math, right? Okay? But the story doesn't end here, ladies and gentlemen, all right? Western philosophy, Western teachings, they don't even teach this part, right? They just keep on saying, hey, slow and steady, just keep on doing what you're doing, right? But the story doesn't end here. What happened afterwards is the turtle got pissed off because he lost, and he said, hey, let me challenge you, Mr. Rabbit, to another race. But this time, I get to choose the track on where we're gonna go. So they choose the track, okay? A different, completely different track, same distance. All right. Rabbit didn't know what the track was, but he was just like, hey, I can go fast and consistent. I'm going to beat this guy again. So they're on the starting line, and they says, hey, ready, set, go, boom. They take off. Turtle's going left, right, as always, right? Going slow and steady. The rabbit freaking takes off like a rocket ship because his idea was fast and consistent, right? And boom, he takes off. But then guess what? He sees the finish line, but right after he goes over this mountain, he sees a what? A ginormous lake. And he stops, goes, stops right in front of the lake, and he's just like, oh crap, what am I gonna do? So he sits there pondering, like, oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? And he's thinking, like, how am I gonna do this? Because he doesn't like water, you know, the water stream is pretty strong that's coming out, right, on this lake. And then he starts to see the turtle coming right behind him, and the turtle doesn't even hesitate. All he does is what? Goes into the water, comes out the other side of the lake, and finishes it, and he jumps up and down like, yeah, I won, right? So what is the moral of that particular race and that particular story? It's about understanding your strength, right? Your core competencies, what you're good at, and then making sure that your strengths and core competencies lines up with the actual field that you're playing in, right? Again, this is a childhood story that's never told in the Western side, okay? And so you're just like, whoa, right? Now, the story doesn't end here, ladies and gentlemen, all right? And this is where it ties into the final story. Because by this time, remember, the rabbit and the turtle, you know, they've hung around. They've been kind of like frenemies, as I like to call it, right? Okay? They're kind of enemies, but they're really friends because they know each other really well. And they said, you know what? Instead of us racing together and always competing against each other, like you said, let's work together. And not only work together, but let's figure out a way to beat the time that you did on this particular track. Right? So they said, okay, fine. Let's not race against each other, but let's actually beat the time that we all have on this particular new racetrack. Right? So they go to the starting line, and guess what the turtle does? The turtle hops on to the rabbit's back. And it says, ready, set, go. And the rabbit takes off. Now, clearly, because he's holding someone else, he's not going as fast as he would normally if it's just by himself, right? But he goes, boom, takes off fast as he can, with carrying the turtle. And then he gets to the actual lake. And then the turtle hops off, and the turtle goes, get on my back. And then the rabbit hops onto the turtle's back. And then guess what they do? They go into the water, making sure that the rabbit doesn't get wet because he can't swim, right? And then he goes across the water slower than he normally does, right? Okay? And then when they get to the other side, the rabbit hops off the turtle's back and then tells the turtle, hey, hop on my back. So the turtle hops onto the rabbit's back and then takes off again and goes to the finish line. And guess what? They beat the time together. All right? Now, what is the moral of that particular story? It's about teamwork, right? Knowing what your core competencies are, knowing what you're strong at, making sure you can control and understand the actual landscape of where you're at. And when you work together, things get done much faster. So as you're thinking about, you know, doing stuff in business and life, whatever it is, right? Number one, just remember, okay, fast and consistent always wins if you're by yourself. All right? You know, slow and steady is better than someone that's going fast but not actually being consistent. But the other side to get things done is making sure that you work together and understanding your core competencies. And when you know that, hey, you're weak on that, ask for help from someone else. And when that happens, magic happens. All right? So again, want to share this with you because of a call I had and a training I had where people were asking about kind of, you know, hey, what are my strengths? What am I good at? And talking about it. So want to share this. Okay? So if you enjoyed it, share it and let me know your thoughts. This is what I got for you. This is Jeff Koga. I'm signing out. Love you all. Take care and bye-bye.